I'm going to read from Psalm 68, verses 5 to 8, and I'm reading from the Passion Translation. And the scripture is this: to the fatherless, he is a father. To the widow, he is a champion friend. And to the lonely, he makes them part of a family. To the prisoners, he leads them into prosperity until they sing for joy. This is our holy God in his holy place. And another translation says, God settles the solitary in a home. And I like what the author wrote, where he says, to the prisoners, he leads them into prosperity until they sing for joy. And that word prosperity is not necessarily financial prosperity, but it's emotional prosperity. It's spiritual prosperity. It's mental prosperity. And God's promise is that he will stay with us. He will stay with us until we come into these areas, until we sing for joy. That's God's promise. And just to give you a bit of background to this scripture, you know, the Israelites, they were coming out of captivity, coming out of Babylonian captivity, and then we're making reference to their Egypt, coming out of their Egypt. And they had come out of captivity, and the families had been destroyed. There was a lack of identity. There was a sense of isolation and loneliness prevailed. And then God begins to give them a sense of family and a belonging as they begin to leave and move from their captivity into freedom. And he begins to give them the promise of belonging to his family, and he restores hope in them. And that is my desire this morning as I'm sharing with you, that God will restore hope in you. God will restore hope in your families. And some of you, your families have fragmented. Some of you, your families have rejected you. And God's promise and my prayer this morning is that you will begin to realize that you are a part of the great family of God, and that God is reaching out to you to invite you into his family, and to invite you into his family so that you come out of your loneliness, you come out of your isolation, so that he begin to set you in a home. And you know, there's a big difference between a home versus a house. You see, many of us, we live in a house, but it's not home to us. Many of us do live in a house, and it is home to us. And bless you if that's your situation. But I know many of you it is not. You may be living in families, you may be living in a house, but there is turmoil, there is upheaval, and you do not feel a sense of belonging. You do not feel a sense of family. And God's promise to you this morning through this scripture that he wants to restore. He wants to restore you into a home. And he wants to begin to work in your life to bring you into the very core of your being, that you belong. And that's the title of my message, is You Belong. I originally had the title message as Belonging, and I just had a sense that it needed something stronger. So I just want to say, you belong. That is the title of my message this morning. And even though you don't feel like you belong, God's promise and my hope is that you will realize that you do belong to him. And you can be part and belong to a loving family. Let me just share with you one of my experiences during, it was during 1974. I think I was around 17, and I had left home rather abruptly, and I started hitchhiking. And if you know anything about the nation of Canada, it's a very large country. In fact, I believe that we are the second largest country geographically in the world. And so I began hitchhiking, And this was during the 70s, and many people were hitchhiking. And there was just a great flurry of people hitchhiking across the nation. And it was a time of people looking for, I believe, a sense of belonging, a sense of reality, a sense of wondering, why are we here? And I know I was part of that search of wanting to belong to something that I knew was healthy, that I knew that would help to complete and help me to understand who I was as a human being. And so on my journey of hitchhiking, I was picked up by many different people. Some were very loving people. Some of them went out of their way. Some would drive. I remember one couple drove 400 miles out of their way for me. I remember this sweet elderly couple picked me up and actually took me to a restaurant and bought me a meal. And so as I begin to experience humanity along my journey of hitchhiking across Canada, I begin to also see another side of humanity, another side that was very broken, another side that was very fragmented, another side of humanity who felt very isolated and alone and did not know who they were or did not feel accepted. And this only deepened my search to find out why I was here on this planet, why I was even here on Earth. And as I began my journey from the province of Ontario to Manitoba to Saskatchewan to Alberta and then to the province of British Columbia, as I began to experience life that I had never seen before, I began to create even a deeper hunger in me to be wanted and to be accepted. And so in the province of British Columbia, I met up with these people, families, and I knew right away that they were experiencing family that I had not experienced yet. And I knew that they were loving, they were accepting, they were honoring, they were respectful. And so I didn't know how to handle this, really. And so as I began to be part of their group, they invited me in, and they began to love on me. And in fact, one couple invited me to live with them. And so I lived with them for 9 months. I had no job. I didn't have any money. Basically, I was living on the streets as I was traveling across Canada. And as they began to love me unconditionally and accept me as part of their family, it really created almost a confusion in me, because I thought, why would they do this? They don't really even know me. They didn't charge me any rent, or they didn't charge me for the food. And in fact, they included me in their family activities. Their family times around the table. They included me. They didn't separate me. When they went to visit people, they invited me to come along. When they would go on vacation, they invited me to come along. And they invited me to meet their extended family. And this was just so amazing to me. And as I begin to see this, and something deep within me begin to realize, this was family. And they were a very loving family who loved God. And I begin to realize that they put God first place in their life. And they begin to live out love, unconditional love of our Heavenly Father. And I begin to see this example. Because you see, before we can speak into someone's life, before we can give them all the nice answers, I believe personally that we have to build a relationship with them. We have to build a trust. And then it just allows them to receive in a healthier way from us. And so this family, they never They never preached to me. They never said to me, you know, you need to get your act together. And honestly, in the 9 months that I was with them, there were times where I did not behave very well. And I would end up at places, bars, and this couple, they would come, and I knew that they felt very uncomfortable, but they would come into those bars where I was drinking, and they would love me. And that took a lot of courage on their behalf, and I began to realize what loving someone was all about. And it just really began to change my heart. It began to soften my heart. It began to give me a sense of belonging. Belonging to a family. Belonging to the family of God. And as I saw this example, I began to realize something. I began to realize that our hope is in God, who is the perfect Heavenly Father. And it was just a very special time. It was a time of stretching for me to trust, because I didn't trust a lot of people. And trust, as you know, is earned. And they earned my trust. And I believe that a lot of churches, and you might think this is a bit harsh, but especially in North America, a lot of churches have made it about services and about the building. And you know what? As I begin to read the book of Acts, and as I begin to read the Bible, I begin to realize that Christianity was never founded on a building, but it was founded on a sense of belonging to God's family, a sense of belonging to families that were under the headship of God. And together it was God's family. And so I believe in the season that we are in, we have a great responsibility. We have a great opportunity to be a family to those around us. Not to do church, but to actually be a church. To actually be a church family. And this is what is really, I have really been, to be honest, focusing on mostly during this time of being isolated. And I would like to challenge you in the days ahead to begin to understand what family is all about. And as we see things being played out around us, and as we begin to see fragmentation of the family and society, may we realize that we have an opportunity to live out as a family to those around us, to be the church family, not to do church, not to go to church, because that we've got it all wrong in North America especially. And I challenge you to read the book of Acts and to see why and how what was known as the early church, how they impacted society so much, and how they basically turned the Roman Empire upside down. And I know we have challenges today. I know you have challenges today. And there's a lot of pressure on us. But you know what? In the early days, in the early church, in the book of Acts, they had incredible pressures. They had incredible challenges. But they still remained as the church family. They still grew, and they grew quickly, and they grew powerfully as a church family. And they were such a great example to the Roman society around them. And you know what? The early church was a grassroots movement that impacted and changed society at all odds. And it grew rapidly. How did they do that? And how did they understand that and reach out? Well, I believe they knew that they were loved by God in the deepest core of their identity. And they knew that they belonged to a loving family. And they were secure in belonging to a family, belonging to families. And as we read in the book Acts, the church met daily. Some of us know this, these scriptures. The church met daily. They had their meals together. They prayed together. They worshiped together. They sang together. They just surrounded each other in unconditional love because they knew they had a sense of belonging in the very deepest core of their identity. They knew that their Father God loved them in a deep way. And it was said, Tertullian, he was one of the early church fathers, said this about the early church. And he was not raised in a Christian home. He came from a pagan background. And he said this: see how these Christians love one another. And that so impacted him that he began to search out further. And as a result, he became a believer in Jesus Christ. And he became a powerful apologist in the early church because he understood, and it was settled, that he understood family in the very deepest way. He understood family, and that under God, there was this one large family. You see, God never designed human beings to be in isolation, but to belong in loving families. And many of us as believers, you know, we think that we are believers, yes, but we isolate ourselves and we stay in our homes and we don't realize that God has called us to be part of a family. And yes, it's okay to watch messages on TV. It's okay to be on social media. But you know, that will never take the place of true family. And as again, as I said earlier, it's not about meetings, it's not about a building. Yes, I know practically it's good to have a building to do things, but that is not church, that is never the church. And so we have to undo some things, especially in North America. And we have to understand what it really means to belong. And, you know, the book Acts is my favorite book of the Bible. And I will go back to it as my reference point every 4 or 5 months. And I will read through the book Acts. Because, honestly, sometimes I get discouraged when I look around. And I realize there's got to be something more than what I'm experiencing as church. There's got to be something more than just coming to a church on a Sunday morning. And I've always believed that the Sunday morning is like, kind of like the icing on the cake. We come together in corporate worship, but you know, we grow strongly as a family when we meet together during the week, when we experience life with each other, when we share meals together, when we laugh together, when we pray together, when we reach out and share the love of Jesus Christ to those around us together. That is true church. That is true family. And so I challenge you to read the book of Acts and see how it compares to where you and I are at today. And I believe that you will know and you will realize that we are lacking. And the first thing is that foundation has to be laid of belonging. Belonging to a family. Belonging to the family of God. And God is family. And we are made in His image. So we are family. And we just have to understand what family means. See, God reached out to humanity. And He released His family on earth. Beginning with a great example is the early church. And how they loved each other. And how they surrounded and protected each other. So I challenge you to read the book of Acts again if you haven't read it recently. And I believe that you will see things. in a whole new different light. And I want to challenge you also this. Judy and I have just read a book recently called First Church Restored by Steve Stewart. It's a great book. And Steve Stewart, we knew him years ago. He was a friend. He's actually our pastor in a church many years ago. And he wrote this book called First Church Restored. And how or why he wrote this book in his travels. He was traveling through India, and he came across this great home church network of 20,000 home churches, 800,000 plus church people, and growing quickly. And he realized that he was in the midst of the same thing as the early church in the book of Acts. And so it so intrigued him, and it so challenged him and convicted him that he began to stay for a period of time, and he began to see that these people, in the very core of their being, understood what it meant to belong to a family, what it meant to belong to families, and to live together daily, as the early church did. And that was so attractive to neighbors and to friends and to society that they wanted in on this. And it was so attractive to them that they wanted to know and hear what was this all about. And it just really opened the door for these people in India to begin to share that God never designed us to be on our own. He never designed us to be isolated, but he designed you and I to be in families, because this is where we belong. This is where we grow. This is where we are healthy. This is where we are changed and understand family in the healthiest way. So I challenge you to even get this book, First Church Restored by Steve Stewart. He has not asked me to promote his book, but I just want to say that it's a book that I recommend that you buy. It's from Amazon. It's called First Church Restored. And you will be amazed and you will be encouraged that even today, that what happened and was experienced in the early church in the book Acts is happening today in India. Not just India. It's happening in Africa. It's happening in Malaysia. And I have been to India. I have been to Africa. I've been to Malaysia. And I've seen some of these home churches firsthand as well. And so I know in a little way what Steve is talking about. But so I challenge you. And so you belong. It's not about belonging to an organization. It's not about belonging to a denomination. It's about belonging to a family, a spiritual family, a church family that understands that family was God's idea from the beginning. And even as God reached out to Adam and Eve, he wanted fellowship. And in family, if we're truly healthy, we enjoy fellowship with each other. So I challenge you. I challenge you, and I want to declare some things over you. And for some of you who do not believe that you can be part of a family, I just want to say this and declare this over your life. So I just want you to receive. And sometimes I like to say, why don't you put your hands in a receiving mode? And I want to declare these thoughts, these things over your life. Amen. Because I believe we have an incredible opportunity in this day to begin to raise up true families under God. So here we go. I declare, you belong. And don't let your thoughts tell you otherwise. You belong, and don't let past experiences tell you otherwise. You belong, and don't let people tell you otherwise. You belong, because God, your Heavenly Father, says you belong. You belong. And I pray that you experience and you receive that this morning. And as God says in Psalm 68 that I read earlier, He sets the fatherless into families. He sets the solitary into families. He is to the fatherless, He is a father. To the widow, He is a friend. To the lonely, I like this, to the lonely, He makes them part of a family. To the prisoners, He leads them into prosperity until they sing for joy. This is our holy God in His holy place. This is God our Father. And if you will allow Him to allow you to belong and to believe you belong, I believe your life will be changed in such a powerful way. And I believe that a whole new vision for your life will allow you to rise up into what God has for you. But you need to understand, you need to believe that you belong. And so that's what I've declared over your life this morning. So Father, thank you. I thank you, Lord, that you declare that you want us to be part of a family. Lord, you are family. It's in your very identity, and you have released this into the earth, into humanity. And so, Lord, as we are healed, and as we begin to trust and to believe that we can be part of a family, Lord, I pray that, God, you will lead these people. You will lead people who are watching this message that I'm sharing, that you will lead them to families. You will lead them to loving families as you did me when I was 17 years of age. You led me to a loving family, and I begin to see firsthand how a loving family under your headship, Father, operates and loves me unconditionally. And my life was forever changed. And I believe that, and I declare this for people as they watch and listen to my message. Amen. So bless you, everyone. I pray that you were blessed this morning. And as I said, it's just been percolating in my heart the last few days, and I believe that God is even going to maybe make this into a series that I can share more revelation with you at what it means to belong to a family. So God bless you, everyone. And if you want to reach out to me or to the church that I'm a part of, the church family that I'm a part of, you please go over to our website, www.citygatestratford.com. And there's an email address on there. You can reach out. Go to our Facebook page, Citygate Church Stratford, and look at some of the things that we have shared on our Facebook page. And again, reach out to us, and we will get back to you. And we would love to invite you to be part and to belong to the family of God. And not necessarily our church family, but to the family of God. Because that is God's will, that is God's desire for your life. In Jesus' name, amen. God bless you, everyone, and have a great week, and we will see you again.